Drew and Paul are on their way to visit entrepreneur Rodger Dudding, who made his fortune by inventing the famous ticket machines that help shoppers queue in order. Having gone on to build a property empire, he began to indulge his passion in classic cars on a truly epic scale.
I suppose the interest in classic cars comes from my late father, who during World War II had a Clino. He would tinker with his car, so I got involved with him sorting the car out. I find it great fun to buy, great fun to collect. Very unusual for a seller car, but we have another Morris Traveller, so we decided that we would sell this Traveller.
Roger.
Hi, how are you? Pleasure.
Pleased to
meet you. Thanks for having us.
Morning, Roger.
Good morning. You've brought some lovely weather with you.
Yeah, I know. We're itching to get inside.
Come and have a look at the toy cupboard.
Oh, my God.
Well, this is part of the collection.
What?
I don't know where to look. I don't know where to go. This is vast and eclectic.
Where do we start?
This is only a fraction of it.
If there is a heaven, I'm pretty sure this is what it looks like. I've never seen anything like it. I have been to museums that aren't as cool as this place.
Nothing really prepares you for coming through the door of this place.
It is astonishing. There aren't words to describe the quantity, variety, rarity and condition of the cars. It's mind-boggling.
Type 34 razor edge.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. Look at that. These cost as much as a real car, don't they?
These are all operational. They're all mechanically powered.
Before you say it, yes, I know it's my size.
It is. It's made for you. This is about the only way you could afford to get a DB5.
So, true, yeah, true. Well, we've come to see that one over there, haven't we?
The Traveller.
Yeah.
Morris Minor Traveller, which is a beautiful, beautiful little motor car.
Love the paint, don't you?
I don't. Well, I wouldn't paint it.
No.
I love it. First impression, I thought, ooh, all the paint falling off it. Doesn't it sit straight? You know, I love patina. I like cars to really show their age, you know, wear it well.
Right, Paul, you know where to check.
The whole car's super solid.
Really?
Yeah. Doors are nicely hanging.
This looks like a super honest car. All heart on its sleeve. What you see is what you get.
I think everybody has a connection with the Morris Minor. For me, two things. My mum had a convertible when I was a kid, and I had one as my first car. When it was first released, it was just a very interesting design. It's beautiful and simplistic. It was the British version of the Volkswagen Beetle. When you look at a Morris, right in the centre, there's this ridge all the way down the centre of the bonnet. When they did the final clay model for the car, they looked at it and thought, it's too narrow. There's not enough space in it. So they literally cut the car in half, added the band to it, stuck it all back together again, and that's why it got the size it is now.
But the most distinctive feature on any Morris Traveller is the wooden-framed rear end. And on Roger's 1969 car, it's starting to show its age.
This looks very old and original. Actually, yeah, looking at this, well, this has started to weather a bit more on this side.
These cars have an ash frame and it's a huge structural part of the back of the car. It literally is the back of the car.
Now, in our car, it looks pretty good. But on the back, the wood's looking a bit soft and squidgy, and that worries me. It's all fixable, but I've got to factor in the money that that might take to fix.
But while there are a few minor patches of rust...
There's a tiny little bleb at the bottom as well.
They always go at the bottom of the wings.
The rest of the car seems remarkably solid.
You need to check the spring hangers in the back here. They always go in the
back. No, they're good. I've checked them already. The chassis is really good. All the wing edges are brilliant.
But for Drew, there's one big problem with the car.
In a market with hundreds and hundreds of Morris Minors out there, I've got to do something different. What they used to do, some of the, like the old Mini manufacturers, a faux wicker, right?
Like wooden picket Mini kind of look.
Like that, but yeah. You can go right back to... They did it on horse-drawn carriages. That's where
You'd
the idea...
You remember, wouldn't you?
That's where it came from. So what I think we do is we do that and then age it, as if Morris did it in the factory.
What Drew wants to do could work, but the problem is to find out whether it does or it doesn't, we're going to have to do it. It's going to be very time-consuming and very expensive. And then we've gone from a car that probably 500 people want to buy to maybe a car that two people want to buy.
I've not seen it done, and I think it will make it slightly more desirable in a very, very crowded marketplace. Wheels. Banded steel wheels. slightly lower profile tyres, but I want to sort of just make it that little bit funkier.
Well, have you gentlemen come to a decision yet?
Do you mind if we take it for a little test drive and see how it goes?
Pleasure.
Righto.
Right, let's go.
Load it, get up and go for what it is.
A speeding ticket, but that should be quite a badge of honour for this, wouldn't it?
Wow!
Oh, yeah. Whee! It's just an out of suspension, this road, isn't it?
Yeah.
Oh, I love that. We're in a beautiful British country lane. This kind of suits the pace of life, doesn't it?
It does. It's a meanderer.
Yeah.
We can just sort of wander about in it a bit.
The power! 28 miles an hour, look at the speed. Let's have a think about the numbers, then. For the car, I think by the time you've done the wheels, you've done the wicker effect, you've tidied a few things up, you've given it a service, I think you're going to be another three and a bit grand on top. Then this car's got to make over 10 grand.
I'm totally with you. Make it something unique, make it stand out. But I want to keep it somewhere near the point I can still sell it to Morris Minor people.
It's just making it different in the marketplace.
How did it go?
Really well. Great. Very sort of Morris Minor-y. It sort of does what it says.
Cute little car.
Cute. I think 5.5 and we'll just drive off into the sunset.
One last offer, 6, and it's yours.
I'm very keen on the 5.5.
I'm keener on the 6.
Can we meet in the middle at 5.750? Marvellous.
Done.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Lovely.
Thank you, Rodger. And thank you for today.
It's a little bit Miss Marple, isn't it, at the moment, so I need to just get it, just bring the age group down a bit. If we do something a bit different with it without spending too much money, I think there's a profit in it.